Okay, so today I'm going to do a short tutorial on how to make an FM blip-blop patch on the Axoloti. So when you've plugged in your Axoloti into your computer by USB and launched the Axoloti software, you're going to do File, New Patch. So we're going to go from an empty patch and see how to make these kind of blip-blop blip-blops that we all like so much. So the first thing to do is go and fetch an object for the audio out. So of course on your Axoloti you've either put a headphone in or it's coming out of some kind of sound source like an amplifier. So I'm going to search for audio in here in the search box, audio out stereo. So this is just an object that if anything that goes into these red inputs are going to come out of the output of the Axoloti core board. So this is the main object if you want to make sound, of course. As inputs into here, I'm going to go and fetch two oscillators. So I'm going to search. So to get this search bar, you just double click anywhere. You just double click and then you put something in here. So I'm going to search for OSC for oscillator. And mine that I'm going to look for is, well, it's not mine, it's the one I want to use, is oscillator sine. So this is just a simple sine oscillator, and this sine oscillator is going to go into another sine oscillator, exciting it. So it can either do it by frequency or by phase. They're quite close, but the phase often allows you to stay into tune according to the ratio you use, and frequency kind of makes it a bit more screechy and actually quite fun. So you can test them both. So what is FM? It's just this oscillator coming into another one and coming into some modulation port. So you're actually modulating the pitch. So let's listen to this. Let's put it really slow, so you can hear that the pitch is going whoa, 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 up and down, vibrato, and then as soon as you speed it up into audio rates, here we have 82 hertz, you get these harmonics that come, very interesting. So this was in the phase, and in frequency we have, you can actually do both, you can have this. It's all up to you what you prefer. I'm going to actually use phase today. So a blip-blop machine, it's these oscillators coming and exciting these other oscillators at more or less random frequencies. So to tune both of these oscillators, I'm going to go using a random source. So I'm going to search for random, and I'm going to use this object that gives me a bipolar number, so between minus 64 and 64, minus 1, 1, each time I give it a positive information in this trigger input. So to trigger this, I'm going to use an LFO, but you could of course use a keyboard, or you could use a sequencer, or you could use a MIDI clock. So I'm just going to use a simple square LFO, and this LFO is going to control more or less my whole blip-blop machine. So I'm going to make several of these random objects so that I'm not always using the same random number. I'm using different random numbers for each parameter. So the pitch is quite important to randomize. The other thing which is fun to randomize is the signal coming from one and going into the other, so the FM amount. So to randomize this, we need to go into objects which is a multiplier. So if we have, there we are, audio rate input, audio rate output, multiplied by a control rate signal. So if this goes into here and then goes into, let's use phase, and then multiply this by a random number. So when you multiply, you can multiply by probably minus one, but you can, oop, that was wrong, but it's, I'm doing stupid things. Ooh, this is fun. As you can see, you can really multiply objects by any kind of signal. So what am I looking for? I'm looking for not this one. Oh, there we are, this one. So, as I was saying, bipolar or unipolar? Let's use unipolar. So I'm going to convert this bipolar random information by using an object conversion bipolar to unipolar and only have positive signals. So you probably don't have to do this, it will probably work very well using bipolar information into this multiplier. And then I should actually have an envelope and a VCA, so let's go and search for a VCA, have the output of this going through the VCA, and to open my VCA I'm just going to use a simple DK envelope, so ENV into my search to search for envelope, and let's use just a DK to start off with. You can play around with attack DK or complicated envelopes. I'm just going to use a DK. So this DK envelope accepts bipolar signal, minus 6464. So I can just go straight into this random information and go into my VCA. So let's just listen to where we are. And we don't have anything. That's fun. Okay. What don't I get? Oh, I know why. I'm not triggering at all this envelope. So, of course, you can play around with the DKM knob, but if nothing's triggering this envelope, this VCA is going to be fed by nothing. So that was a simple, stupid error. So here we already have one kind of blip-blop machine, which is quite interesting. As you can see, I've got no way of controlling this randomness. So a simple way of controlling this random number is putting it through a simple multiplying object, but this time only blue-blue, because it's only control rate. So this random information will then be multiplied by something that I can control, so a dial, and it will be a positive dial because I just want to either multiply by nil, nothing, zero, and send me zero, or multiply by the, one or anything in between, which will control my amount of randomness. So I'm going to put this on the other pitch, and I'm going to also put a control like this onto the FM amount, and actually the DK too, might as well. So here I'm just control C, control V, copy and pasting these two objects. This one is going to go into the multiplying. And then I said for the DK. So this will make it much more controllable already. So this gives a bit of randomness into the DK. Let's give a bit to the pitch. Oh no, this is the FM amount, sorry. One of the pitches of the carrier, and this is the modulator. And you can, of course, still play around with the pitches here to make them higher. you wanted to control this with a MIDI information, so either if you had a MIDI controller or anything that sends MIDI CCs, and you want to control the pitches and these amounts, you just right click MIDI CC and put the CC number that you're using. And if you've got no idea of the MIDI CC number you're sending, you just get an object called MIDI CC, so MIDI in CC, and press take this one, MIDI in CC INE, and then display. Here are all the display objects, very useful for understanding sometimes what's happening. And I'm going to display an integer. And I want to display the values of my CC. So I haven't plugged in a MIDI controller, so I'm going to quickly do this. There we go, so this is plugged in normally, and if I go live and turn a button, see here I'm turning one button, it's 10, 11, 12, whatever button I'm pressing, it tells me the information I'm sending. So if, of course, your MIDI controller is a bit old and keep on sending silly information in all directions, it's quite hard to understand, but this is a good way of finding your MIDI CC configuration if you don't know it. Anyway, all that to say that I can now control these dials using a MIDI CC, or if you have GPIOs and POTS on them, you can use GPIOs for this. So this is a main object. If you want to make it stereo and a bit more fun, you can also actually take the signal coming out of you can actually put an envelope on the modulator. So let's just use this VCA and the same kind of envelope, so decay envelope. Not forget to control the decay. And this will be now the decay of the modulator. So this goes through the VCA and then comes into this modulation. And what we can also do is, instead of only having one FM loop, we can actually feed back the exits of this one into the first one. So that way you can really have strange modulations in all directions. So I'm going to just duplicate this object, which is the times object, which will be the FM amount, and have this sound coming back in time and coming to excite this oscillator. And to control this, I'm going to do the same thing. That means have a small control the amount object, so it's just a multiply. Instead of this, you can actually do a multiply by C. So if I search for multiply by C, this is exactly the same thing. It's multiplying an object by a number, which is between 0 and 64, which is the same thing as me using this positive unipolar dial going through this multiplier. I prefer using this because you can always change and put an offset or that kind of thing afterwards. So this is going to go into this multiplier, and I have to give my random information a trigger. Okay, so I think I'm going to take the right output and put it on the other VCA. So here I've got in one ear my second oscillator being modulated by my first oscillator, which is going into my right input, and this oscillator is modulated. So they're both the carriers and whatever, it's big loads of feedback. So let's put all these down, no more randomness. this is the decay, and this is the second feedback. So you can really hear these second harmonics. So, I mean, this is already quite exciting and quite fun as an object. You can play around with the offsets and controlling these objects a bit better. I'm not sure if you've seen, but I'm actually using 5-6% of the whole DSP, so I can do loads of these if I wanted to, or do put them through delays, or which I would definitely recommend is going into some reverb of some kind, and actually a modulated reverb is quite fun too. But this is just a simple, quite nice sounding reverb from the rings port. Mutable instruments, anybody? So let's put a bit of reverb. So there you go, this is a short tutorial on how to make a blip-blop FM machine. I hope you understood something, and I hope you enjoy making these things, because that's where most of the joy is. Voila.